Hi there, Internet. I'm Polar the Polar Bear, and welcome to another episode of Polar Bear Plays. We are smack dab in the middle of Lifeless Planet, and the planet is not as lifeless anymore thanks to Aleda, the poor Russian woman who they did terrible genetic experiments upon, who sacrificed herself so that the planet might be green again. And I'm not really sure what our objective is now. We were following her previously, but now that she's gone, I'm not really sure what our motivation is, except I guess to try and get home. Ooh. Thank goodness for my jump jets. Otherwise, that probably would have been death. I still wonder if this whole thing isn't a hallucination brought on by, like, this guy's in a coma, or, he attempted suicide maybe after his wife was found, after he found his wife dead, or maybe he, got hit by a car, or maybe he just laid down next to her in the forest. I have no idea, but at the very beginning of the game, you saw, like, a bed. And I don't think the wife was in it, because I think, from what the story seems to be, the wife was dead when he found her in the forest. So if anybody's in a coma, like in a hospital, it's this guy. And yeah, we kept seeing that bed, so I'm thinking it's a hospital bed, and that's where he is. And we're going to find out this whole thing was just a long, complex hallucination, and that Aleda was some weird representative of his wife. That's just a theory I... Oh, gravity balls! It's just a theory I have. Let's try that again. Yep. Yeah, okay. And across here. And you do have a little bit of air control to the left or right, but you don't really have any back or forward, which makes sense, I guess, if you're using jump jets. Okay, big satellite for some reason. I wonder if this is the surface of the planet, like if this is just how the surface of the planet is now with all the green fire moss having been restored after Aleda gave herself to that creature. I don't know what good a satellite's going to do me though. If I'm really assuming this isn't some sort of weird coma fever dream, and I'm actually 15 double light years from Earth, 13 light years from Earth, or 13,
so
30.
The other portal does lead back to Earth, but hundreds of years in the future.
Portal time. Da-na-na-na. The portal of this planet was a one-way transport mechanism, as we discovered following our initial arrival. We originally assumed it would work like any doorway, that we could return through the same portal at our convenience, but this was not the case. Thankfully, we eventually discovered the second portal, the departure portal, leading back home. This two-portal system was actually very efficient for transport purposes. We developed our settlements appropriately to regulate travel back and forth as necessary. What we didn't comprehend at first was the lost time encountered through the portals. While transport happens quickly, time on Earth and on this planet are not in sync. We soon realized a week on this world was a month back on Earth. When the portals failed, this time disparity became great. When the arrival portal malfunctioned and killed so many people, we became afraid to use the departure portal to return to Earth. Over time, we started to see images we did not recognize on the other side. There were strange, towering structures, much more advanced than anything we'd ever seen before. Some believe the portal had recalibrated to the homeworld of the portal creators, but I knew the truth. The images of the portal were Earth, but centuries in the future. Unfortunately, we never tested our hypothesis given the completely unstable power reactions from the portal. It was far more likely we would suffer a tragic transportation accident like our comrades from home attempting to reach us. There were no volunteers and eventually no further opportunities before the portal went dark and cold. In retrospect, I wish we'd taken our chances. Yeah, seems like the better thing to have done, really. Huh, so this departure portal leads to Earth centuries in the future. That is interesting. So if I get to the portal and return to Earth without becoming giblets, I'll be returning to future Earth. And it wasn't the alien homeworld, it was just us having advanced technologically. Oh man, that creature. It is huge and awesome. But I have a feeling it's going to try and stop me. Oh, there are several of them. There's another one back there, and there's one over there. Oh man, those are really cool. I wish I could get like a closer look at them. They just seem to be sort of compilations of writhing plant mass, but... looks like my way home. Unless it turns me into giblets. Please don't turn me into giblets. I would really not go that good with gravy. Like there's, yeah, just nothing left to do but hop on in. Unless I can get to that, I'm gonna see if I can get to that creature. It'll probably just, like, if I get to it, it'll probably just murder me, but I'd like to see it up close. I probably can't even get over there. Oh yeah, no, there's totally an invisible wall up there. Oh well. Into the portal we go!
As I understand, you've kept your wife on life support. It sounds like you haven't been able to let her go.
Actually, I did it for her. I want to give her every chance to live again. Even if I'm not here.
Ooh, what is this? Oh, almost look like a pillar of bone. So, going through the portal, I entered some kind of... oh no, that was just my memory. Beautiful, if starkly white, city of the future. A little bit more texture could have probably been used on those buildings. And that is the end of that game. And let's see how much time we have left on the clock here. About 5 minutes. I may not even go that much over on this one. Oh man, alright. Just gonna stretch here real quick, and then the sun has actually got... I started filming this at like, I don't know, till at 2, I think, and it's about 7 right now, so yeah, that was an all day let's play. Totally worth it though. I mean it's purely an exploration game, which might turn a lot of people off. I know a lot of people aren't too into that, and I totally don't blame you. But me personally, so long as what I'm looking at and exploring is neat and interesting, I'm totally cool with straight exploration stuff. So in that aspect, I quite like the game because I felt that while the environment was a little sparse and I would have put more stuff in it personally, in every stage really. I would have added a little bit more detail to the world as far as like models and stuff go. In the desert, you could have had like interesting rock formations or just models of like not necessarily tumbleweeds.
What would you miss most about Earth?
Oh, we got more. Well,
my wife, first of all, and Earth itself, all of it. She saw the beauty of this planet long before I did.
You truly loved her?
Of course. And if you lose someone you love, even 20 light years probably isn't enough distance to make you stop missing them.
What? Alrighty. I wonder what that was all about. So as I was saying, maybe to the lava area a little bit more, because it was pretty, maybe the lava area could have been lightened up a little more, too, because it was really dark and kind of difficult to discern which parts were lava, which parts weren't lava, what the correct direction to go in was, and it was kind of, you could call that in the name of exploration, but it was kind of hard to explore because everywhere you went, you caught fire. So not so bueno on that. You could have had like more active lava flows, stuff like that going on there. Just kind of generally a little bit more clutter, I guess, is what I was looking for on the ground. A little bit more clutter, maybe a little bit more detail in some of the textures to add that kind of, like, neat, this thing I'm looking at is neat kind of effect. Overall, it was good. I mean, it didn't have a lot of scenery in a lot of places, but the scenery that was there was really cool. The big dead plants, the ancients, the portal creators' kind of odd geometric creations. The portals, the light bridge is always a cool concept to use. I liked the story. I thought the story was it wasn't. It was told primarily through audio log and notes and whatnot, but I thought that was done well in this game. It seemed to come across pretty well, especially because you were even if indirectly you were interacting with Aleda, the Russian woman, pretty much constantly up until the end when you started those big creatures started popping up, which the portal creator creatures. Which I thought were really awesome too. I'd like to see more. I'd like to see. I don't know who the devs are for this. I'm gonna find out. And I'll put it somewhere in the. Hopefully, I'll put it somewhere in the description for this video. If not the other videos. If I forget to do that, somebody remind me in the comments down below because I want to do that. I'd like to see another game. Sort of in this style by them, in which they get to experiment a little more with creature creation, because those plant creatures were really cool, and I'd like to kind of see what else they could come up with. So I'd really be interested in seeing something like that. The creature, there weren't that many creatures again, but what were there were cool. The jumping for the most part was fun, especially when you got like the 8 or 9 jump jet. That was a lot of fun. Though I will say again that the physics engine, as far as rounding off the edges of stuff and your character moving kind of like you try to move him backwards, but he's facing forward and he has to do a real, like an awkward circle and he falls off of something. It could have been smoothed out a little bit, and you know, trying to like you're on the edge of something, you try to jump and it pushes you off backwards. That could have been smoothed off a little bit. My timer just went off there to let me know that I'm done with the regular episode length. So yeah, this isn't gonna go over that far at all. There's really not much more to say. I mean, if you thought it looked neat, go pick it up. If you want to see kind of more, be in the environment, go grab it. Not an excellent game. Fun, but not like, you know, there's not... It's mostly a sightseeing tour, which, again, I can get behind, but I think if you're going to do a sightseeing tour, as much as I did like this game, what you really need to do is make it non-linear, in the sense that you have an idea where you need to go to advance the story, but you can also kind of wander off the beaten path and go poking around in caves, go poking around in forests, jungles, whatever, and seeing just neat stuff that, you know, the designers just kind of threw out there to decorate the world. And there wasn't, and this was just pretty much just a straight walk from one end to the other, with jumping puzzles and whatnot. But for the most part, it was just kind of a very linear succession, which brings it down from like awesome to good, you know, pretty good, but not amazing. Still do recommend though. Just I'd say get it on sale if you can. I got this as part of a Humble Bundle, which I paid $6 for the bundle, and there were 6 games in it. It was one of the Flash bundles, so this was like $1, which I'd say it's worth like $2.50, $2.49, whatever. I think that's about all I have to say. So kudos to the devs for putting together a cool cool environments, cool creatures. I'd like to see more of it. I'd like to see it done in more of a kind of a, not necessarily sandbox form, but more of just a open world kind of format where I could go poking around and just kind of, you know, see neat stuff that's been put in various places. So I think that's going to do us for Lifeless Planet. Probably the next... And hopefully they'll get... I've created a ton of content today, so hopefully by the time all this is posted, Screen 7 will have gotten back to me. If not, I might do Dark Out, I might do Vanish, I might do Shattered Memories. It was Shattered Memories. I still don't know what that game was called, that Slender game, but Haunted Memories. Haunter... I don't know, something. Something with Slender Man in it. I think it's supposed to be Slender Man. I don't know. It's a free horror game on Steam, and I think it's a Slender Man game. And I don't normally touch Slender Man stuff, just because it's been done, and it's really not, like, that interesting, but I've seen a little bit of gameplay footage, and it looks really well polished, so I'm going to go ahead and give it a try and post my attempts, because I'm sure it's going to be hilarious watching me, like, freak out, if indeed I do freak out. And at the very least, it's a... From what I hear, it's a good kind of creepy horror game. So, that'll be coming up at some point. Thank you guys so much for sticking with me through this Let's Play of Lifeless Planet and through my incessant rambling at the end of Lifeless Planet. I hope to see you guys again for whatever's next very, very soon.